Are you ready to move up to level 2 of video creation? I think of level 1 as recording one straight take and uploading directly to the web. Level 2 is doing some basic editing. I'm Brighton West, and today I'm going to show you how to use free software on a Mac to edit video that you recorded with your iPhone. The first thing you're going to need to do is record some video on your iPhone. So you can either do that with the camera app or with another third-party app. I like something called Filmic Pro, but it's definitely a little more complicated than just the camera app. So I'm just going to go into the camera app. All you would do is swipe to the right and get to video there on the bottom, and make sure you hold your phone sideways, and then just go ahead from there. And you can see my breakfast that I just finished eating, and record your video and click stop when you're done. Great to have that on a tripod or on a selfie stick to make sure you have less jiggle. But the assumption is you've already done that. Now let's get into what do you do after that. So what I'll do is I'll just plug in my iPhone to my computer's USB port with that lightning cable, and then it's going to pop up iPhoto. And first thing I'm going to do is actually close iPhoto because I don't want to use iPhoto. And the next thing I'll do is open an application that's already on your computer called Image Capture. So just go into Applications and then Image Capture. Then it'll find your iPhone and list it there. So I'm going to go through and now choose the videos that are part of my video project. And actually, I'm going to do this one here. So there's three videos. I'm going to hold down Shift when I click on this to get all three. And then I'm going to choose where to import it to. So I'll go down to Other, and I want to import this onto my external hard drive. So as you start making more and more videos, you're going to want to have an external hard drive to store all this stuff because video takes up a lot of space. So I'm going to go over to this hard drive and just create a new folder, and then choose that folder and click the Import button, and it's going to import those couple of movies into that folder. And once that's done, you can just close out of Image Capture, and you're going to open up iMovie. So head down to Applications and open iMovie. And iMovie, if you're not seeing it on your computer, you may have to purchase it through the App Store if you go up to the Apple and then to the App Store and type in iMovie, just depending on when you purchase the software. So this is a project that I work on last. I'm just going to get out of that in the upper left-hand corner. And I'm going to click the plus to create a new project. And I'm going to choose a movie. And there's lots of options here that you can choose kind of how you want to put it together with nice little themes. But I'm going to choose no theme. Double click. And then it's going to ask me to name my movie. And this is something I don't like about iMovie is you can really only put it in the iMovie library. So I'm just going to call this Marin Berries. And it's going to then open the project, and I can import the media. So you'll look over on your external hard drive where you put that earlier today. And you'll see the files that you pulled off of your iPhone. And you can just click on these, hold down Shift to select all of them, and then import all. And there are your movies from your iPhone. And what you can do is just take these and put them down on the timeline. So the bottom is the timeline, the top is kind of your library. So let's take this, we can actually select the part that we want, just clicking there, and then inside there, take it and drag it down to the timeline. And you can take the edges of these and change them. Just if you click here, you'll see that change to an arrow and make them longer or shorter. And on the bottom, you can actually see the volume. So this is a spot where I'm speaking. This is a spot where I'm not speaking. So you'll go through and clean this up. Maybe you'll cut off the ends. Maybe you'll, kind of add some clips together and you say, okay, well, I want to see that box down here. So let me take it. Sorry. So you decide you want to see that box down there, so you can take it and decide how much of that clip you want. Take it down here. And then once again, you might want to shorten it on the end. So once you're happy with what you have set on your timeline, you'll head up to File, and then you'll Share. And I always choose to share to a file. You can go direct to YouTube or Facebook or Vimeo. I like to go to a file first. There's definitely some SEO benefits here, but that way you can store this on your hard drive and you've got everything on your hard drive. If something happens, you can always go back and get it. So this is gonna be an iMovie with audio and video quality. You can set these different things, compress. I'm actually gonna go for a better quality compression and then click next. It's gonna ask you where to put it. So you'll head back over to where you were storing your files. And just click save there. And it's gonna export that. And you'll notice in the upper right-hand corner, a little kind of a clock here that's showing how long it's going to take. So then you'll head over to your browser and go to YouTube. Log into YouTube if you aren't already logged in. And you'll head up to the upper right-hand corner. Once you're logged in, of course, you see your avatar. Click Upload. So you'll find the file in Finder and on your external hard drive. And just take that file and drag it over onto YouTube. And it will start uploading. So you can set up all your metadata here, your title, your tags, your description. And when you're done, you can publish it for the world. Okay, iMovie comes free on new Macs, but you'll need to buy it for $15 from the App Store if you have an older Mac. And if you're willing to part with $100, I highly recommend ScreenFlow. There's a link down below. Thanks for watching. If you are looking to make videos for your business, then be sure to subscribe to my channel. Each week, I post new videos to help you learn about online video. Click the subscribe button now.